I'm gonna go fact check that, Jim. I don't even care. Let's go fact check. 1 out of 10 versus Protoss lower than his MMR, he says, huh? 1 out of 10. Check my last 40 games. Oh, great. He's probably been mid-throw. Oh, great. I catch you. Oh. You're at 5,900. Let's see. Okay. Okay, Rob is basically your level. That isn't even match. I am not counting Rob. You beat Rob here. One Protoss lose. Up! Up! A ZVZ versus the Blazer. Let's see where the Blazer is currently MMR-wise. Whoa! I was reading chat! Uh-oh. Uh-oh. It's all coming undone. It's all coming undone. Where are you? Like, what? Like, okay. This is why you can't play NA. Like, look at these games you're playing, dude. Look at how many favorite games these are. Okay, you lost to Pilly. Pilly has more MMR than you. That does not count. Dude! You're literally playing Protosses that are better than you. At least MMR-wise. I mean, like, look at these games, bro. I don't even know where I am. Am I here? Oh. You're kidding me! No! No! You look at the build you did! Look at the build you did! Gas pool! Overlord speed! No lair! A bunch of Zerglings! Useless! He blocked my two expansions? You know what? You know what Jim is like, guys? Let me tell you what Jim is like. Jim will get abused. Like, okay, for example, Jim, you've played 3,000 games this season. Don't you think it's time to learn how to beat a can rush? I mean, Jim, let's be honest. Like, why can you not bring one drone down to your low ground for like 20 seconds? You literally never lose to a cannon rush. We should tweet Rogue. Did you see the games that were cannon rushes, man? Yeah, all these Zergs are greedy. Dude, look, guys, how many Zergs do we have in the stream? Press one if you are a Zerg player. Press one if you are a Zerg player. Let me tell you how it is, Zergs. Us Protoss players, the hardest matchup to beat a cannon rush, it is PvP. That's a fact. Okay? That's a fact. So you come to me and you complain about the cannon rush as a Zerg player. Like, Protoss players have literally, we scout for the cannon rush at 1 minute to 105 every game. Every game, we scout for the cannon rush. And if I lose to a cannon rush that I don't scout, am I like, oh, this is too unfair? I'm like, well, I shouldn't have played that greedy. Turkey. On a scale of, we got a cannon rusher in here. Turkey, on a scale of 1 to 10, rate Jimrising's ability to handle a cannon rush. On a scale of 1 to 10, rate his ability to handle a cannon rush. Jim, you are a good player. You're not a bad player, Jim. But your ability to handle a cannon rush, it's like 80% mental. It's like 80%. I don't know what it is, dude. Like, I'll throw down a forge, and I'll just take both my hands off my mouse and keyboard, and I'll still win the game. I don't even know what happens. Like you're okay once you get to that mid-macro game. You still make some mistakes. Your late game, look, I can help you out, Jim. I could help you out. I seriously could. Like, you're close. You make a lot of decent moves, but you also make some moves that, you know, there is some improvement you could do. There is. Oh, here we go. Okay, this is perfect. Look at this! No! Jim! You didn't scout a Glaive-All in, and you didn't make a Roach Warren. And he comes in here, and he plays victim. You gotta be kidding me. You don't scout. Dude, that's like me not scouting your Baneling bust and me being like, huh, I wonder why I lost to this Baneling bust. I guess Banelings are too strong. Jim, these games, man. Why are you not opening Overlord speed? What is happening? You skipped Roachworn, and I bet you didn't even scout. I'm glad he beat you. I can't wait to look at this. You got 3-0'd by Antis' Protoss. This is not on me. Let's see what's happened here. He went double Stargate, it looks like. Jim, you lost at 16 minutes in this game. Your drone count's too low as well. Jim, let me coach you. Jim, you subscribe, I'll give you more tips. I feel like I shouldn't be giving you so much help for free. That's what I feel. I just cannot win versus Toss. I study every day to improve and stop complaining, but all I Jim. I'm gonna type a word in the chat for how when I read Jimrising, I don't complain about Protoss. That's what I think. Little Kappa. Don't complain about Protoss. Are we being true to ourselves here today, Jim? Are we? Teach me how to beat the race made by the gods? What type of line is that? I thought you don't complain about Protoss. What's happening here? My god. Don't bully him. Look, I gave Jim some compliments. Like, Jim is not a bad player. But Jim does make... You make a lot of the same mistakes, Jim. You make a lot of the same mistakes. And, like, I could help... The thing is, like, if I start helping you, then you might be able to beat me. Not that you don't beat me now. You know, we're pretty even out there. I mean, I have a bit of an edge. But we're pretty even. Let's not get sidetracked. But I could help you, Jim. I could help you. The thing is, you know, it's so much of your mental that... That's your issue. Honestly, it's like 90% mental. I swear to God. Like, you getting 3-0'd by Antis on ladder. I mean, there is nothing in there that tells me that you played like you should have, man. Of course, if I think the push won't kill me, it won't happen. What push are we talking about here, Jim? What push are we talking about? Still not accepting Cannon's OP on Triton. It's not OP on Triton. How does that sound? Demi, do we need to give you the same lecture? These Zergs, man, guys. Where are my Protoss brothers? Can I get a one in the chat for my Protoss brothers? Protoss brothers, I'm speaking to you directly now. These Zergs. They just play so greedy. Every game. Like, there's like two or three good Cannon Rush maps. And it's like, there's two or more or less two Cannon Rush maps. Okay? And these Zergs act like the world is coming down on them. And it's like, why don't you just play a little bit safer? You know? Why not bring a drone down? Because if you, let's say you always lose to a Cannon Rush. Well, maybe we should start preparing a little bit. You are automatically behind. This happens to Terran. Poor Terran's taking third base, and Protoss is ahead already. Jimbo. Hold on, I'm getting a phone call. Yeah. David Kim? Yeah, it's Jimrising again. I know, you gave him literally free scouting in the last patch, and he's still complaining. They didn't need that Overlord speed buff. You're not wrong, Dave, but you gave it to him. And it's like, as a Protoss player, we got the biggest Zerg map pool in the history of Zerg map pools. You know? And it's like, just get Overlord speed and scout. Wait. Wait, you were watching him get 3-0'd by Antis' Protoss? What do you say about Protoss? Oh, that's good. That is good. That's Jim. That's Jimbo. All right. Good talking. All right. Catch you later. Sorry. Oh, I wasn't muted. You know, it's crazy, man. As a Protoss player, guys, I'm telling you, man. We play safe. We play smart. When we see that there is potential danger out there, what do? We prepare ourselves, man. That's just the way it is. That is just the way it is. My God. Jim. I want Jim to say one compliment about Protoss. I will give Zerg players a compliment if you give Protoss players a compliment. Don't give me a meme compliment. Don't be like, Protoss players know how to abuse builds. I want Jim to muster in his heart a compliment about Protoss. That's what we need right now. Look, Huck, a retired player, Overwatch guy, here we go. Beat me yesterday. Can we see the replay? Jim, I could give you some tips. You give me the replay, I'll give you a live coaching session. I'll do it. You or Huck drop the replay, I'll go through it. I'll point out some mistakes. Look, this, you can't put a value on what I am offering here. You can't put a value on it. Because it's like a professional player giving you potential coaching. Join me. Okay. Here we go. Am I not friends with Jim? Join the Zerg OP channel. I think we're friends with you, Jim. Okay, here we go. Jim has terrible early game ZVP. Jim, did you see that? Let me just stop there. That is a fellow Zerg player calling out your early game. And it's like, look, chat, I get it. You want to say to me, chat, how does Zerg have a weak early game? You just make a bunch of queens. and you make Overlord speed. You know, I don't really know how you have a weak early game as a Zerg player, but I guess it's possible. I guess it's possible. I will help you. Guys, what I'm about to show, look, this is honestly so important for players because they don't see it from the Protoss side. Jim only sees it from the Zerg side. But I'm here. I'm basically God in this scenario. Where Jim is down on his luck, he needs a divine spirit, a la me, to come and intervene into his life and tell him that it's not the way it is, you know? But what do you say about Hugh Marine and Special saying Toss is easy as using an iPhone? Can I get a bless RNG? Can we get a prayer up for Jimrising? Jim just told me that two of the notorious Terran whiners think Protoss is easy. Whoa. Mike. I can't even believe it. Next he's going to tell me Demuslim also thinks Protoss is tough. Like, come on, Jim. My lord. Jim. Special literally told me that Zerg is easier than Protoss and stronger. That's the truth. That is the truth. Versus Terran? Jim, start the game. Just start the game, Jim. We've lost Jim. What's this guy saying to me right now? I can't even piece it together. All right, here we go. Let's lock in. Let's help Jim. Let's help our buddy Jim. Because Jim needs us, guys. Jim. Okay, here we go. Right into the den. Okay. All right. Hello?
Hello, Chris. How are you?
I'm doing all right, man. You know, there's this guy that's kind of bugging me. He thinks Protoss is overpowered, but I'm here to help him. How are you doing?
I'm good. Okay. This is helping me, you know. I can win versus Protoss, so this is helpful.
Uh-huh.
But I really hate your race.
I thought you said you didn't balance whine about Toss. What
it's
happened?
So hard. I don't know. It's hard for me. Maybe Serval could be everyone, but I can't.
Are you admitting that it might be a little bit of user error in some of the play? You know, like...
So, no, that's hard English. What the fuck?
You say Serral can be everywhere, but you can't. You basically are telling me that you're not good enough. Is that what I'm gathering?
You have to be at certain level to beat. I mean, it's not easy, you know?
Oh, what, Jim?
Yeah, he can rush at the last game, so...
Jim, it's Thunderbird!
Yeah, he can rush it. Yeah, they don't give
a
fuck.
He can't rush on this map.
I lose here versus Green Reaper at Turkidano.
Okay, those guys, I can... This is not a strong can rush map. Well, go back. Bring me back.
Why?
Bring me back. Go back.
No. The last time I ignored it,
Just pause. He made it back here. You can't cannon rush well back here.
Dude, it's an A. You can say that. They don't give a fuck.
What does that mean?
Jim, yeah, they don't give a fuck. They build so bad and it's work and it works.
What? You're saying your defense needs work?
Yeah.
I'm trying to help you. Like, okay, this map. Okay, do you know if you were? What would you say are the best two Cannon Rush maps, Jim? There are two maps that are much better than the other maps at Cannon Rushing.
It's not about the map, Chris. They
it
can
is
rush
about the
in
map.
Any map.
It no, is. It is. Well, yes, I agree. You can, if you are a good Cannon Rusher, you can do it most maps. But there are some maps that warrant a different response. Like Thunderbird, this natural is not an easy one to wall his Protoss. So if he started walling back here, I don't know. I think you could do a later drone pull. You could have forced him to commit, and then you could have pulled all your drones, and he would not have been able to hold.
Yeah, maybe two drones, but I don't know. He just kind of rushed me the last game, and I was like, I'm pretty sure he knows he can beat me, and I was like, okay, I need to defend this.
I'm saying on a map like this, you could let him can rush, because the way you can rush in the back here, it would be tough. Like, you could pull all your drones. I don't know. All right, whatever. Let's just move past it. But, like, pulling all your drones so early, I mean, you'll never get the can rush up. I don't know. This is okay for you still. I would say this is fine. Because he did open forge, right? He did open forge.
Actually, he tried to cannon rush. I didn't see.
Yeah, he opened forge.
Motherfucker.
This is good for you. You should see this. You should be happy.
Yeah, I was happy. I was like, motherfucker.
Okay. Only one overlord. Little bit greedy. Would you agree it's a little bit greedy, only having one overlord across the map? I mean, you really have, like, you have no idea what's coming. I mean, you saw the forge, so you should know that.
All I know is I'm ahead.
Yeah? Evolution complete. Do you always skip Roachworn? Okay, there we go.
No. Okay. No.
You could have been in trouble to a Stargate. I guess you have a guy in his base.
Yeah, but I'm scouting, and I saw the DTs. Okay.
This is perfect for you. Oh.
Jim. Yeah, but I didn't scout
the... Do you not make spores, Jim? Yeah. Okay, the spore's coming up. I like this.
I made two because I saw it pretty late. And he didn't realize I didn't put the spores, so...
Your forces
this,
are around.
Okay.
This was good for me.
Yep, this is good for you.
Yeah, we went full NA here. Bot.
This is fine. I hand cam can't see. Okay, you're droning up. I like this. Your overlord spread, Jim. Top of your base, mid, also the airway in the middle left. Okay, there you go. Spread it out. A little bit late, but you got there. You're getting there. Okay.
Look at my drones. I'm fine.
Your
warriors should
engage the enemy. Your drone count's so low, actually. I don't know. I feel like I need control to get a real grab. I'm just going to focus on you. Okay. Well, I'll say something. Swarm Host Nidus, now that's smart.
Why not?
No. Swarmos Nidus is incredible. Now I'll see how you handle it, though. Attacking the gateway before the pylon, that's kind of an interesting choice. What's your drone count here?
You're engaging the
66.
Your forces are taking damage. Evolution complete.
So I saw him coming, so more drones is dead. New queen.
Yeah, this is looking good for you. I mean, look at the supplies. Yeah. I mean, yeah, you have
and weapons. I lost. Surprise. Hell, carriers.
You're late game, Jim. We'll get there. Mutation complete. So creative. Okay, like this is.
Look at this.
Yeah.
Look at this damage, and I lost. What the fuck?
How could you not blame yourself
Middle
here?
Field depleted. They're attacking your base.
I lost
now.
To an Overwatch guy. What the fuck?
We're running out of minerals back home.
I mean. Well, I can't wait to see attack. You throw this, see I gotta jump. Say. You gotta do some serious throwing here. I mean, this is all good for you.
Yeah, what the?
Wait. A little bit left. Those swarm. Oh, here we go.
Oh, yeah.
Tally it up. Tally it up. There's
this
number.
Was a mistake?
That's
okay, okay. This was a mistake because I wasn't paying attention, but. But he lost the Nexus, and I did damage. What the fuck?
Okay, yes, but then you threw away your entire army for basically free.
Yeah.
The game was over if you don't do this. Also, your Swarmhost ability, you could have been harassing more. It took a long time to get this second Nidus up, did it not? You could have been a little bit more on top of that Nidus. There's no about it.
Look at this. Look at this. I kill another Nexus.
Yeah, you got
and
slows.
I lost the game. I lost the game, man.
I mean, you just, okay, think about it. You just lost your like almost your entire army, and then you had to remake a bunch of roaches. You had to make a bunch of army that is not good as the game goes on. I don't know how you lose this, to be honest. He doesn't even have a fourth base taken yet.
I don't understand.
Do you not go Mass Infester? You go Corruptor. You go Corruptor quite a bit, actually. Plus you're on Mass Roach. Okay, see, look at the supplies, Jim. And you're floating 1,500, 1,300.
Yeah, because I'm saving for Broodlords.
Yeah, but you like, okay, pause it. Because, okay, you can't throw away a lot of your army and then just make Broodlords here. Because how else, now you can't really harass, now you can't really do a ton of things. It's literally like me as a Protoss player pushing out.
But he won't attack. I have enough spines. There is no sense to make army. Why? He won't attack.
But you don't want to
and
throw
if he
away
tries, your... I just...
But
if,
those
I mean,
last
if he
two
tries,
army...
I just make...
But why would you throw away your army? Like, those two trades
because
you had,
it was
of
a
course,
mistake.
The one time you got caught, which obviously, I mean, mistakes can cost you games, let's remember that. But also, like, that last fight, I mean, how much did you actually lose there? Quite a bit. And now you look
I don't know. Yeah, I lost a lot. Yeah,
right.
I lost a lot. But,
so that was
but,
another...
Okay. Yeah. But you are just telling my mistakes. What about his mistakes?
He should lose
his game.
Okay, he hasn't made the... The thing is, he hasn't made a massive mistake in a way that you had good defense for a while, right? You didn't take much damage to the DTs, and then you killed two Nexus. The thing is, what other mistakes has he made here? He's lost his Nexus... So, you are just so far ahead here.
That he's trying to kill my Overlord with the Zealots and Immortals. Look at this, and I lost.
Why aren't you popping another Nidus up? Where are your Swarmos? Your Swarmos play could have been... Plus, again, like... Wait a minute. You haven't even started your Greater Spire.
Yeah, another mistake.
Yeah, your bank is a bunch of money.
Yeah, no. But no. Here it comes. Like 20 seconds late. Why is that a problem if I'm making damage?
Hey, your base is
because,
under attack, man.
How you can't have this timed where, like, when your hive is coming up, your greater. I mean,
mutation complete.
Okay. Even still, the thing is, okay. So if your greater spire is so far away now. Think about how long you were sitting idly, and now you're making these there's so much time you're doing nothing
here.
Your
warriors have engaged
right?
the enemy.
Pause it for a second. Because think about
what do you mean nothing? I'm doing damage.
You, well.
And I'm forcing him to multitask, like.
A little bit.
Something like you guys don't know.
Jim, let's keep it civil here. Those Protoss players now, hold up, coming at me like that. Now. I mean, like, think about it. You threw away one... what? You threw away so much of your army that now your presence on the map is like 100% Broodlords. And you have no... Why are the Infestors not pumping out? You were sitting on 1,500. Why do you not have Infestors yet? And the thing is, he could attack you. He could have attacked you here because you literally have... Let me look at your army, Jim. Let me move my hand cam. You have 3 roaches, 9 swarm host, and we're 11 minutes into this game. Do you not see an issue with what has happened here, Jim? Okay.
No, I don't know what is happening. Tell me.
You're saying you're doing damage, but you're clearly hurting yourself more than you're doing damage. It's like, okay, Jim, let me compare it. It's like me playing a PvT, and I keep sending a bunch of DTs to harass. And it's like, yes, I'm getting some done, but I've spent so much on these Dark Templar that I didn't tech up, that I don't have as strong of an army. That's pretty much what's happened here. Where you've thrown away so much in the mid-game that you're not able to get a bunch of Infestors. You're not able to get a bunch more drones and more defense. Like, yes, you still have 73 drones, but you're just, like, your late game, you should have had more here. Because what happened is you threw away your armies. So then you had to remake more army. And then you made a bunch of spine crawlers because you were scared you were going to get attacked because you threw away... Like, your massive Roach Ravager army should never really have died. I mean, obviously you threw it away the first time. I get it. You make a mistake. Although, let me point out that mistakes can cost you games.
Would you? Yeah, makes sense. At some point, but I have really bad experience versus Puck. Whenever I remax with Rogue Traveler, I just disappear versus 3 High Templars, 2 Immortals, 1 Zealot, my entire army, my 200-200. So,
Jim,
I see more efficiently if I skip this mid-game army and I just make Broodlords, and I take more like games from Puck than using army.
I mean, we can look at a game versus Puck if you want. I mean, my issue is what you just said, is why are you at a spot where you have to remax on Roach Ravager? Wouldn't you say that's kind of an issue?
Because it's a mid-game army.
Right.
We are in late game right now.
I mean, it depends on the situation of the game, but if you're ever having to remake Roach Ravager, like, there has to be a certain point where you have defended and you can get to Broodlords. Like, I know Puck plays pretty aggressive in certain times, but, like... I know, Puck has a bit of a different style than most Protosses, right? He doesn't even go for, like, carriers much. Oh, I'm looking at not you.
Yeah, but they have spines. The thing is, this fucking prism. I was pretty greedy here, so...
Imagine if you had your army from earlier. You would have cleaned up this at the front so easily, and you would be able to counterattack. Like, he's all in here. He's all in.
Yeah, but the thing is, it's not smart to make a lot of roaches and Ravager if he has a storm, but I never realized he didn't make storm.
I mean, it's okay to have roach Ravagers or storm. I mean, yeah. You want some Banelings. You should be adding You can never
decide if he has a storm or not. You have to say, yeah, he has storms.
There should be a period of time you should also be making a Baneling nest and Baneling
storm. Yeah, but,
What? Because, like, yeah, okay, wait, right here you've been just insanely insane punished because he's on 3 bases and you're now morphing 6 Broodlords. And, like, you take game losing damage here. Really. I mean, he's all in, but, like...
Yeah, but, okay, he's making the damage that I did, so the game will be even, okay?
I mean...
We will be even, right?
I mean, the issue is he's floating so much, and that's when this comes back and helps him, because he's floating so much money. It's like, you kind of would be even, but since he has such a massive bank...
Yeah, but I have tier 3 units.
But you can't do anything with these tier 3 units. You've warped them in at home, and now they're just sitting at home. If you push them across the map right now, and you make a bunch of corruptors, like, let me see what you make. Jim, okay.
What?
Nothing. I mean, you're getting +1 melee here at the end. Not sure why. Now you're getting
+2
melee. Like, okay. Why are you not attacking here? You just took basically game-losing damage.
Because if I attack, at some point I will lose my Broodlords versus 1 Void Ray or something like that.
You're way too scared,
yeah.
Sky Toss.
2 Void Rays, sorry.
You're good. No, Jim! Jim, if you counterattack with these Broodlords, you would have killed the 4th and the 3rd, and then you wouldn't even needed Broodlords to finish the game. It would have been like Hydrodan or Corruptors or something. You realize that. Like, look at his army. Now he's making 3 Void Rays, but he still has no... He has 2 Void Rays out. You could have gone across the map. You could have counterattacked and won the game.
Yeah, the thing is, I'm like a Chihuahua dog. I'm so scared right now because I know what you are saying. I'm always, or I used to be like that. Oh, I have Broodlords and I can counterattack and win. Yeah. Whenever I try, that fucking Puck kills me with just 12 Stalkers, my fucking Broodlords. And I'm like, is this really the stronger unit from Zerg? Are you fucking kidding me? That's why my CVP it's so this. A lot of distortion in my gameplay because of the fucking Puck killing my Broodlords with 3 units.
Well, okay, if he is literally... Okay, if Puck is beating you with ground and you have Broodlords, you are making... Maybe you should have something, I don't know, let me think, to support those Broodlords? Maybe have you thought about Lurkers underneath those Broodlords? Maybe Infestors underneath those Broodlords? I don't know, maybe even Zerglings underneath those Broodlords? Now, yes, he's going to have Storm, so probably Lurkers would be a good bet. Infestors also a good bet. The thing is, if Puck is on ground... You never have to attack until you've just choked him out, more or less. Because ground is not going to beat a good Zerg late game. Would you agree with that?
Not for me, but yeah, people say that. But
what does that mean exactly?
I have never experienced that.
You have never.
I mean,
so
I have never experienced the late game Zerg. I always lose at late game. What the fuck?
Okay. Yes, I would agree. Your late game needs work. And a lot of it comes from the fact that why was there no one faster? You are more of a corrupter broodlord guy. You overmake broodlords, really. Most of the time. You overmake broodlords. Would you agree? Mm-hmm. Now, maybe versus Puck, I would agree mass broodlords are good. Or could be good.
Your warriors have engaged the
but
enemy.
Most of the time, I mean... Because, like, what will happen, Jim, is you will play mid-game... And you will commit so much to Roach Ravager or like a Baneling composition, and you'll commit so much to that, you'll commit so much of your money or gases to that mid game, that once it becomes late game time, you don't commit to the late game.
Our forces are under
attack. Still making mid game units. You need to be making it. You should be massing investors. Why are you not massing investors?
I don't know. To be honest, from my experience, I don't think they are pretty good.
Your forces are
before
taking damage.
Before the Broodlords, I always diversify.
Okay.
No, but whenever the Protoss is attacking me, it's more than 6 or 8 immortals. So if I make Infestors, I'm not gonna make anything with them. Anything. So
I see more efficiently to make faster
Broodlords.
Yeah, you can go for faster Broodlords. You can go Broodlords and turn Infestors.
I can make Infestors. Yeah.
Right. I would also say,
but I make Infestors here. I'm pretty sure I made. Look, wait.
Okay, is this game?
This game is not over. It's
6 Infestors. Yeah, you've really massed them up. That mineral field's gone. Don't spend okay, here we go.
I killed one carrier with 28 Infestors. Okay.
Your base is under attack. You're engaging again. The opponent. A creep tumor is under attack. Okay.
Let's see. Let's witness. Okay, you cannot be losing this game, Jim. Now that you've got this many bastards out.
Yeah, and I was like,
wait,
okay, people say he's OP. I'm sure I'm going to win.
Pause the game.
Guess what? What?
Jim, okay, I guess, to be fair, I have not paid 100% attention, but how do we have so few bases and you have so much money? You should be taking the top and the bottom if he keeps taking both bases on you. If he keeps taking this bottom up, like, you should not be losing these bases that easily.
I didn't have the enough army to defend my bases, so it was pretty hard to get another base.
I don't know about that. There was a long time your army was... Because, like, okay, you say this is a good example, and now I will agree that this spot I like for you. I like this spot for you. I will say that you almost should never lose this game. Now...
you will see.
I mean, okay, you also... Let me look at something. Hold on. Jimbo.
Yo.
Do you think it is a fair assessment that we need to be scouting our opponent's main base more as the game goes on? Just check in at where they're at.
I don't know, two or three times in the entire game?
Look at your vision right now and look at your opponent's base.
Uh-huh.
You really have no idea where he's at. Now, yes, you've seen his army.
No, but I was attacking with the Corruptors to catch the rally point units.
You haven't seen any of the Stargates or anything. I mean, yes, you obviously know that there's a million voices.
No. I knew. Yeah, of course he was making Tempest or something.
We had to go Stargate because you had 25 Broodlords. But...
Yeah.
I don't know. Also, my issue as well is you see this army without Storm. Like... Your army composition here, I mean, like...
It's so good.
You should have had more... Like, okay, when you see this army, when you see a Protoss that has 7 Immortals at 17 minutes, you should pause, go call your best friend and say, I've just smacked this kid on the ladder. That's what should happen. Because, like, how can a Protoss ever handle Sky here? He has no Infestors. He has 11 Void Rays, right? Yeah, you should be mixing in some Vipers. You should be mixing in... Like, okay, you have to play the part. I would say this game, now, I still think you should be able to win with 60 Infestor, but, like, like, do you need this many? In fact, this is a game Mass Corruptor would have been good. If you had 25 Corruptors, you never lose this game. Would you agree?
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
So maybe you didn't have a correct tabs on his army, or at least a correct enough tabs on his army.
I don't know. I knew he was making mass Skaito, so...
Right. Well, you knew... But the thing is... Okay, it's like if I'm playing you and you have 10 lurkers. There becomes a certain mm-hmm. point where your 10 lurkers make your big army bad. Because you have 10 lurkers mm-hmm. that don't help you for Skytoss, right? So you see him with all these immortals, you should know that, especially now that you're maxed, your army should be way better than his. Because he has he has a lot of units here that will never help him kill your god army.
Yeah, makes sense, but I cannot let him to make his game, so I was using the swarm host and the roaches to defend Zealots and to harass.
Okay, to be fair, swarm host not your best defense unit at this point. And like now at the game, like, you've lost all your spines. You should have remade a lot of your spines. Spine crawlers are so good late game to help defend your bases. I mean, that was obviously a bad trade for you. And obviously the Swarmos are not going to get a ton done now, right? That time for them getting a lot done has passed. You're bleeding off right here.
You need to see the last engage. I mean, it wasn't the best, but I don't know. I just killed one carrier. What the fuck?
His army is bad, Jim. Okay, again.
Yeah, and I lost. Guess what?
You just bled off six infestors without me seeing what happened.
You will see. I don't know, maybe...
Well, we lost six. No, you just had to remake. Okay, now we're up to 24 infestors.
Yeah, I was making more infestor. And I was like, okay, more infestor, more chance to win. And guess what? I lost.
Your forces are under attack. Also, note, you have 8 Swarmos giving you no help here.
Yeah, that's right. Here comes my rage. I was so fucking mad. Because I was like, are you fucking serious? I lost to 5.5k player? And then someone told me it was Hawk. And I was like, what the fuck? I lost to below MMR and retired player. What the fuck? I felt worse.
I mean, okay, you would also agree your drone count is way too low.
They're attacking your base, you know.
I mean, yes, you have an okay army. You should never have low.
Oh, no, look at this! Look at this! I denied these bases.
So well, he's also denying your bases.
Your
I'm seeing a lot of red.
Yeah.
So
yeah, but I have infestors.
Okay.
I'm playing the OP race, right?
Okay, pause it. You lost a ton of your static D for free, I will also say. Your static D is pretty important. Would you agree?
Yeah.
Okay. So maybe you should consider, because you got to pick your battles, right? Like, you killed this base, but look at the situation of the game, especially now that I blow it up. I didn't know it. Like, you killed a base that has 4 mineral patches left, Jim.
Yeah, but then I'm going to the top to deny that. Or bot, I don't remember. Let's see. Yeah, let's...
Our forces are under attack.
He's mining way more than you right now.
Yeah, but... That will change in a moment.
You're being outmined hard in the late game. Hold on, pause it for a sec. Let me get an upgrade check. His upgrades are better than yours, I will say. All right, he's going to be on 333. You're on.
But I have infestors. People say he's OP.
Well,
so I'm supposed to win. I don't get it.
Those people are right. Okay, you can continue. Give it to me. I'm ready.
What?
Continue.
Hey, your base is under attack, man. Mutation complete. You're engaging the opponent.
I mean, you have some dead supply here.
Oh, by the way, I forgot my Broodlords in the last engage, but... But I don't know.
Are you preparing me to tell me when some of your important units were not there?
Yeah.
A creep tumor's under attack.
What does he has? Like 4 Stalkers, 2 Immortals, and 4 High Templars!
Yeah, you should still win this game. I'm waiting.
Yeah, I'm not lost.
Wait, you just told me you forgot your Broodlord's gem. Okay, Tempest do basically nothing, so you should just act like they don't even exist.
They're attacking your base, you know. A creep tumor's under attack.
Like, this is fine. I mean, it's scrappy, right? It's scrappy.
Your
trade base
for
base here. It's gonna come down to the fight. How are you gonna play the big fight, Jim? How are you gonna play
okay.
the big fight? Okay.
Look at this bullshit. I mean, I fucked up, but what the fuck? I just killed one carrier.
What am I watching, Jim?
One carrier, man! Okay, and one boy tree. Okay, two boy trees. Two boy trees and one carrier.
That's your takeaway from this.
Of course, I can win this game with the Infested Terran, but he's not dumb.
What do you mean? You literally...
Denver is talking about this. Okay, yeah, Infestor is it's strong, but they just need to run away from the...
That is literally exactly why they're changing the Infestor. You realize that. Because right now, you cannot run away from the Infestor. Well, you can run away, but there are infinite Infestors. Let's bring it back. Let's rewatch the fight. And except, yeah, you literally. Okay, yes, you need your Broodlords here. By the way, like the fact that your Broodlords here are a massive deal. Let's not act like you forgot a few Corruptors in the back. Kind of like your main piece of your army. Let's keep that in mind. Okay, you literally ran these Infestors. Pause it. Oh yeah, no, you're right. Keep going. You gotta lead with the Infested Terrans, Jim. If you don't lead with the Neural Parasites.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, right here.
Yeah, I know I took a bad fight. Yeah, I know.
Okay.
But people say this unit is OP, and I just killed 3 units.
Okay, you literally can't say that, Jim. You can't say, I took a bad fight, but this unit's OP, so I should have won. You can't tell me that, Jim. That's exactly what you just told me. Exactly what you just told me, Jim. Is that not what you just told me?
Yeah, maybe.
Because, Jim, if you lead with a bunch of Infested Terrans and then 2 Fungals and then the Neuros, you still win this game. But, okay, let it play. So you throw out 4 Infested Terrans. Look at how much energy are on these Infested Terrans.
Yeah, because I was clicking to Neural. Neural Parasite.
But the thing is, you weren't safe to Neuro. You just gotta rework. You might have to rework your late game hotkeys or something.
Your forces are taking damage.
Like it was not safe to take that fight with those investors that exposed. Like of course.
Yeah, but I felt so behind. I mean, I cannot make spores or something like that. I felt so behind. So
you felt
I was
behind,
like,
yes.
I need to fight now.
Well, you didn't need to fight now. You guys just traded all your bases. It was coming down to one fight, no matter what.
Yeah, but I don't know. I always feel behind. I mean, not behind, but weak. I always feel my army is shit versus the army. You know, I mean, when I play versus Terran, it's like, are you really wanna kill me, motherfucker? I just fucking A-click and Terran disappear.
It's mental,
it doesn't
man.
Matter if it's your thermal, it's special. I just fucking A-click and they disappear. But versus Protoss, Overwatch player could disappear me.
Oh my God. Look, I'm not gonna lie. This is an embarrassing loss for you, Jim. You're not gonna. I'm not gonna take that away from you here. But Jim, like, that you cannot bring me balance with this game. Okay, you made. Do you want me to bring you through all the mistakes we went through in the game? And why you lost? This had nothing to do with your arm being weak. You made a lot of mistakes, and you were still in a spot where you should have won this game. Would you agree? Would you agree with me, Jim, that if you played this exact last fight out 10 times, you should win 9 of them?
Okay, what if we try?
Okay, let's try.
Oh, but I have to change the fucking
interface. You should be winning this late game fight.
Okay.
Okay.
So I need to change the interface. Wait, let's remake.
Okay. Because, okay, but the thing is, I will say this. You were in a good spot multiple times. But, Jim, yeah, in for future, you don't have to get so aggressive with those roaches. Especially, you should just keep dropping down a bunch of Nidus. And maybe trading in roaches like that. Like, you were at such a good spot. Like, when you kill a base with the Swarmos, you should basically never be losing. It's like me going DT drop and killing a hatch. I should basically never be losing. Right? But you threw away so much after that that the game became even again. Like, your mid-game... Like, it's like me trying to transition to carriers, but then throwing away my entire Protoss ground army. Special... are you seeing what Special's saying in the chat? He couldn't win. Yeah.
Yeah.
So
we can try, and then Special could try.
Special said you didn't change the interface. We can't take over.
No, I changed. I'm fine.
All right. Are you sure? Are we going to sit here 25 minutes?
I'm sure.
Okay, I'm trusting you. I'm going to rewatch from your... I didn't... You're saying I had to change it. Oh, I didn't change my interface.
No, but you're fine, right? No, you're fine.
No.
Yeah, you're fine, dude.
I think I have to be on...
Oh, mames, Juan! Este sinvergüenza dice que Protoss es débil, güey.
Jim, are you bad-mouthing me in another language right now?
No.
What's going on here, Jim? Let's keep an Americano here, my friend.
Jeez. I didn't say anything.
All right. I don't know. Jesus Christ. My lord. What's going on over there? Jesus Christ. I'm excited to rewatch this. Okay. Your warriors have invaded. I mean, just look at the income right now. Like, you're still in a great spot, and you took two really bad fights that you did not need to take.
We're running out of minerals back home.
Yeah.
Mutation. Your forces are taking damage.
So, like, here, hey, I mean, you said you forgot your Raider's Spire. I don't know.
Yeah, for 20 seconds.
It's just such a long time to be floating money, though. I don't know. Like, mineral field. I don't know. I feel like there's something wrong going on. I just don't know Zerg enough to just yell at you right now. You know
why I did forgot it? Because I was multitasking.
Oh, here we go. Yeah. Let's go back to right when your high finishes and let's see the multitask you're doing. Let's go
that
back.
The most multitask you do is up and low and low your disruptors. Up and down. Up and down.
Let's go back.
Down.
Let's go
That's
back.
All you do.
No, let's go back. I want to see the multitask that made you.
I'm
forget.
The god of multitask. Look, they are attacking me. Then you chief and you defend everything. That's your multitask.
No, Jim, go back. Let's see the multitask you were doing that distracted you. Let's go back. Let's find out, Jim.
No. Let's go to
okay,
the
okay, okay. Like, we're
I
moving
need
on.
To,
all
I
right.
Need to
all right, we're moving on.
Mineral field depleted. You're engaging the opponent.
Jim, I could show you a game of Zerg overpowered. I'll be Zerg being OP if you want. There's a game
okay.
I ran into two base.
Yeah, but I have to go soon. Okay. I mean, I have like 10 minutes. It's pretty late.
It's only 5:40 in the morning.
Yeah, it's pretty late. I have something to do tomorrow.
Okay.
I mean today.
Yeah, it's incredibly late, Jim. A creep tumor's under attack. Jim.
Yo.
Will you subscribe to me if we go this entire distance? And
I am a subscriber.
Oh yeah, someone gifted you a sub.
We're running out of minerals back home.
I gotta start treating you with respect, my man Jim. Zerg is weak right now, Jim. Right?
Hey, your base is under attack,
amen.
Man.
Keep that sub coming. It was a sub gift. I know, Jim. I know it was a sub gift.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy. Hey, your base is under attack.
It's a trap.
A new. You're under attack. Siege up.
Yeah, you got some haters in
your
here.
Your forces are under attack.
Special saying again. Some not good things about what's happened to you, Jim. Jim!
He's mad because I lost to Psycho.
No, no, no. Jim, this is a great learning experience for you.
Yeah, I'm learning. Like, I'm really trying to learn because...
Well, because...
Okay, I cry... Oh, yeah, yeah, I'm a whiner, yeah, of course. Yeah. I accept it, but every day I try to improve. Like, okay, I'm a whiner, but every day I'm trying to improve. So I don't care if they laugh.
That's my new sub notification. Thanks, Jim. They're attacking your base now. But Jim, okay, pause it for a second. Like, okay.
What?
Wait, what was I going to say?
Oh, but that doesn't mean Protoss is not OP, motherfucker.
What do you mean by that exactly? Okay, Jim, you... Like, I don't even know. I don't even know where to start with you exactly because... Like, okay, let me give you something real here, okay? You should be happy when you watch this replay. You should be in your room, jacking yourself up because this is, look, it's like in a game of StarCraft. Just because you lose doesn't mean it was all bad, right? Because you got to think about it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You got to think about it.
Because I'm not a top tier player. Yeah, I understand.
No, because. If you, like I said, if you got to the spot of the game you were in for most of this game, there were multiple spots in this game. If you could start, when the game starts, if you could get to that spot, you're going to win almost always. So it's about getting to that spot. So like it's like if you always mess up the late game micro, you can fix that. Like your micro, you can get better at your micro. You're getting yourself in spots where you should be winning. And that is good. Like, you should be happy about how you got to some of these spots. Especially, you were in some bad spots. You mean, you were in some good spots, and then you were in some bad spots. But then you were in good spots again. And it's like, when you are in these spots, like, especially this last fight, but I mean, multiple times throughout the game, you are literally, like, if a game started, and I offered you the spot you were at, you should
be winning.
Yeah,
it's hard to lose.
Right.
But somehow, Jimrising always lose. What the fuck?
You can fix that, though. Like, you can, like... I'm trying. I don't know. I feel like you say you're trying, but then, like, you get past like 15 minutes into the game, and like, your mental is just too fragile. You need like you've just like defeat yourself in the late game. I don't know how exactly. Because like you're getting in spots. Like if you are in these spots, you should feel like okay, this is a really good spot for me. And it's like I said. Like maybe you just need to get me in an afternoon and we just keep working on your late game control. Maybe that's what it takes. Maybe it takes 3 hours of someone just keep replaying from the late game control. Because like I said, I tell my stream sometimes, if you get into a spot where it just becomes the only like the micro, like let's say you are in a spot that you lose 100% because you're micro. Like let's say I disrupted a bunch of my own army. Like, I was 100% going to win a fight, but I disrupted my own army. It's like, I still want that spot because my micro, I can get better. I'm in the winning spot I want to be at. Like, you are in the spots you want to be at. Your control just isn't there. So you should be happy about a lot of this. You should say, look, you should turn this positive where you should be like, look.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You are talking about the spot, yeah, but most of my games.
Okay.
Yeah, like 9 out of 10 games, it's like cheesing and all-inning me with pros. It's not like this game. It's hard to get here.
It's not though. You need me in your life, Jimbo, because
yeah, because everyone it's like, oh, Serik is OP. I'm gonna lean because I cannot win, and I'm like, are you fucking serious? Just make storms.
You know what
survive.
Upsets me, Jim? I respect this. You are a like guys. Jim is a grinder. He puts in a ton of hours on stream. He's always there. But man, the fact that I am piecing together 8-9 hours a day, people are hearing this fake news you're throwing at him, Jim. I mean, come
What's
on.
Fake news?
What do you mean? You're that.
Yeah.
You're,
what do you mean?
You're literally the classic Zerg player that's like in Diamond, and you're like, oh, I can't win because it's unbalanced, even though the games have nothing to do with balance. It's just completely all about the player playing.
Okay. Look, okay. If I lose one game, I'm like, oh, this is fucking bullshit. Okay, next game.
No,
wait. Okay. Next game, I'm like, okay, it's same build. I need to try something different, like maybe one less drone, maybe one more drone, maybe two more drones, maybe fourth base faster, and nothing works. And there is a point that I'm frustrated. Like all I have to say is fuck this.
Yeah, I mean,
it's not about I'm doing the same thing every time. So I can never see the light versus pros. Never. Even if I play versus a special, okay, look at this. A special is way fucking better than me, like way better. And I can take maps from him because of the balance, because Zerg is Imba versus Terran. Okay?
I mean, so, I don't know if Zerg, I mean, Zerg is definitely good.
I compare this with like a players with 600 MMR difference beating me. It's like just bullshit.
Dude, I lose to players 500, 600 MMR below me all the time. It just happens. It just happens. Like, there's a reason there's 600 MMR below you. Like, you're obviously, like, 9 out of 10 games, you're going to beat Huck. Or probably, like, 8 out of 10, you beat Huck. But, like, you'll lose occasionally. That's just how it is, man. I mean, we're not great players. That's just how it goes. I mean, dude, also, give yourself some credit, dude. The reason you can take a game off special is not just because of Zerg and balance. Like, you're not a bad player, Jim. Like, you're a good player.
No. You are trying to justify it, and it's not. It's
justify
because
what?
Zerg it's Simba versus Terran.
I mean, Zerg I'm not supposed to take
maps versus the best Terran in the world.
Yes, you can.
Out of Koreans, right?
Yes, you can.
No, of course not.
Yes, you're at a level where you could take maps off nearly anybody.
I don't know.
Dude,
let's try, man. I need go.
Okay, but dude, okay. Just think about it though. You're able to lose to someone 600 MMR below you. Why can't you beat someone 600 MMR higher than you? It goes both ways. Like you could beat a lot of all the top guys, but it's like obviously we're inconsistent when we do it.
Okay, are you ready? I'm gonna try better. Okay.
I don't know if I'm in this game, Jim. I don't think I can take over. Okay, I'm ready. Okay, can you assign me to Ire?
No.
I told you, Special was right. I had to change my interface, man.
Oh my god.
I had to change
a standard brain protoss player.
You said you had it. And then I said, okay, I'd have to change mine. And then you said, I don't know. And you just said, it's good, it's good, it's good. And you kept going. Just play the. Let me see you beat the computer, Jim. Just run it through me, and I'll watch. I'll watch you take
no,
down.
No, it won't attack. It won't attack.
I know. Just watch. I just want to watch anyway. I want to watch. Just let me see you go to work here, Jim.
Oh my god. Okay, this is my last because I need to go. Okay.
Special saying you can't do it either. Okay. Okay. Let me see you do this.
This is my moment.
Take down this late game toss army.
Mineral field. This is my moment.
You're up in supply. Infested Terrans first. Infested Terrans first. Cloud.
Oh, he's
kind of over that ledge. That's a good spot for the Protoss. That's a good spot. Okay, yep. Keep firing. Yep. See, could have thrown in some fungals as well. More. Okay. Oh. Come on. Focus fire.
Oh my god.
Bring in the corruptors. Bring in the corruptors.
Mcanning, thank you for the coach.
Get the Fruit Lords in. So
yes.
You're welcome, Jim. You're welcome. I told you. I knew you could do it. I knew you could do it, man. I knew you could do it.
Okay, too much troll. Okay, well, I'm done. Just try it with special if you want. What do you want the replay?
No, it's okay. We can work on something later, Jim. And like, look, I'm telling you. Somehow, you're also losing to mid game Protoss more than you should be losing to mid game Protoss. We'll work on that. We'll get there. Special wants to play me with it, okay?
I send you the replay on Discord. Yeah, just try it. I need to go.
Okay. Thanks for your time. Have a good
okay,
night.
Okay, bye.
Goodbye, Jim.
Bye, stream. Thank you.
Guys, show Jim some love. Unbelievable. See you later, Huck. Get your claps in the chat for Jim. Maybe a heart. Good sport. Guys, the thing is, let me tell you, chat. Let me let you know something, guys. The path to righteousness is not always easy. And today, give it up for him. Hold on. Hold on. Today, Jim took that first step. Today, Jim said, I'm going to put aside my differences. I think Protoss is strong, but I'm going to try to get better here today. I'm going to get better here today. He said, I know. Mcanning, this replay is ugly. I had about 10 throws. But I'm going to try to get better. Yes. Yes, you can, Jim. Yes, you can. All right. Special, are we doing? Do you actually want to play your Zerg versus me trying to control Huck's army?